Hey everyone, this is Josh from Muscle Shirt Productions, and my next review in the Scream franchise is Scream 4. I remember seeing this at a midnight showing on Thursday night, and the theater was packed. Everyone had a good time watching it, and though I had fun as well, there were a lot of problems I had with the movie upon my first viewing. Aside from the newest one, this is the second one that I've seen the least of after Scream 3, so I had to rewatch it again for this review. Have my opinions changed on it? Are they the same? Did I have a change of heart? Find out in this review of Scream 4. Out of all the Scream movies in the franchise, this is the one where I have the most mixed views on. Mainly because while there was one thing I liked about it, there was always something else I disliked. For example, when I first saw the movie in theaters, I really liked the beginning with the two false intros of Stab 6 and 7. I'll admit, they did get me, and I had a lot of fun watching them. But after some rewatches, the fakeouts lose their novelty fairly quickly, and takes away from the suspense and runtime of the actual start of the movie. You could find an alternate beginning of the movie on YouTube that I thought was better than the theatrical release. Speaking of the beginning of the movie, I really liked Marco Beltrami's new take on his score. It's more bombastic, and I love how it ties in with the song Something to Die For by The Sounds. Once you hear that, and you see the Scream 4 movie title, you can clearly tell what tone the movie was going for. This movie was meant to be a fun horror movie, and the movie score along with the soundtrack really helps give off that fun vibe. Before I get into the new characters, I'm going to talk about the original three. First of all, I love how Sydney is brought back. It makes sense to me that she would make a self-help book to help others, and that her book tour would go through her hometown. I also like that she still has family members in Woodsboro because that makes her return all the more organic than forced. I like how Dewey's a sheriff now and is acting more serious because, well, he is the sheriff now. And I like the marriage dynamic between him and Gail and how she is struggling with her career and using this as an opportunity to get back into the swing of things. I've said it in my previous reviews, but once again, this is a natural progression from Scream 3. The same cannot be said about the new characters, though. In my opinion, including the new movie, this is the weakest new cast in the franchise. My problem with them is that while they may have had little quirks about them, or they may have said funny lines here or there, or they did something to be a red herring, it's not enough for me to actually care about them. I found most of them either boring or annoying, and this was the first Scream movie where I kept saying, "Can you just hurry up and kill them off already?" The character I can actually say that I liked was Judy Hicks. I know that a lot of people like Kirby, but I found her to be overrated in my opinion. It's cool if you disagree with me, and I wouldn't mind seeing her again in a future film if her character is handled better, but I find her to be okay at least and overrated at most. As far as Ghostface is concerned, I thought he was more vicious than the previous installment. Now that it's 11 years later and the creators are not hindered by national tragedy, they were able to bring back the franchise to the way it was intended. The kills in this movie are more graphic and Ghostface has a new energy and is more intense in this movie. I must also compliment this movie on its use of technology. I liked the Ghostface voice app, and though I found Robbie annoying, I enjoyed his live streaming and thought it was ahead of its time. Something else I must discuss is the cinematography in this movie. Scream 4 does get some criticism about its look, like it's hazy or the lighting is overexposed at times. It's something that never really bothered me, but I did definitely notice it upon my first viewing. Now, I'm aware about technical decisions that are made on movie sets, so I just figured that it was done on purpose. And after listening to another YouTuber, 3C Films, review of Scream 4, he does mention that Wes Craven said it was done on purpose to let the audience know that this was supposed to be the beginning of a new trilogy. As far as the killer motives are concerned, I actually liked it a lot. I liked how they mentioned how the new horror movies like Saw were popular at the time, and I liked their take on remakes and reboots and the social commentary on wanting to be internet famous. This movie has aged well, in my opinion, and I also like their spin on the new killers in this movie are the new Randy and Sydney. I guess my initial main issue with the killers was that I didn't find them physically intimidating. The scene where Jill beats herself up was entertaining to watch, though, and Charlie does mention he did most of the kills himself. Another YouTuber by the name of Zach Cherry said that it makes sense for Charlie to have done most of the work so Jill could really come across as innocent to the public. But even with that in mind, I still didn't find Charlie physically intimidating either. But I guess it's just a nitpick at this point, and it didn't ruin the movie for me. As much as I enjoy the hospital scene and the funny bits of dialogue between the characters, I just can't get over the fact of where the nurses were and doctors and other patients. We only see one nurse in the hallway, and that's it. Even though it's acknowledged in the movie by Gale as a joke, it still doesn't excuse where all the hospital staff was. Despite my problems with this movie, I still enjoyed it. One thing I love about the Scream franchise is how it's always able to reinvent itself with the changing times. And just like how the new Scream movie came out, as long as there is another story to tell or another take on social commentary and pop culture, I will always continue to see a new Scream movie. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and until next time, this is Josh from Muscle Shirt Productions.